I think you can talk to me, isn't it?
Amen.
I greet you all in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Much better. What a wonderful day that the Lord has given us. We are blessed and privileged once more to gather in the presence of the Lord. We still celebrate, what the Lord has done for us.
Amen.
By sending Jesus to come and be a replacement for our sins. May you shout amen, somebody.
Amen.
We thank the Lord that He has been so faithful to us, even when we're not faithful to Him. Because His God is faithful and He remains faithful.
Amen.
I want to greet each and every one of us in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
We are taking this time seriously because our lives start on a day like this one. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why am I saying this? The death of Jesus on a Friday. It was doomed according to other people. The church did not have hope. The church was seriously in despair on a Friday when Jesus died. Saturday morning, on a Sabbath, nobody was allowed to move around and do anything. These people were seriously gloom. They were not having hope whatsoever. Thank God because of women. Let us say amen.
Amen.
On a Sunday morning, women moved from their houses with prepared spices or perfumes. They went to the graveside, and when they got there, their amazement. I know you know the story, but allow me to say it as it is. They discovered one thing very important. The thing was, graves during those days were carved on huge rocks. The same applies to the rock that Jesus' grave was. And the nice thing about it was, immediately after the women arrived, they discovered that the huge rock that was the stumbling block for them from seeing Jesus and embalming Him with all those wonderful spices was rolled away. And as they were still amazed, an angel of the Lord appeared to them and asked them a serious question: why seeketh thee the living among the dead? You might not understand it until you understand the prophetic call upon the life of Jesus. It was prophesied more than 600 years ago that a virgin will give birth to a child and he shall become a son. Apart from that, this wonderful son will become a counselor. I thought maybe somebody would be relating and say, thank you, Jesus. And from being a son, the government shall be put upon his shoulders. And from there, his name, because of the government upon his shoulders, shall be called Wonderful Counselor. He would not end there, or he was not meant to end that right there. The Bible Bible goes on to tell us that after becoming a wonderful counselor, he became a mighty God. And after becoming a mighty God, you are not God if you have got limitations. That's the reason why we don't worship people. Because they die, they perish. He was also meant to become everlasting Father. Say amen, somebody. And from being everlasting as God and the Father to the fatherless, he now became the Prince of Peace. He made peace with God on our behalf. Our sins had made God angry. But he became a replacement. He said, "You're going to punish me than these people." Oh, what a beautiful love upon his people. Where else have you seen a God such as Jesus? Who says, "I'll go and die on their behalf. I'm going to be beaten, smitten, and spat on, crucified, and maimed just for them." It is a beautiful story. And indeed he died, and today we are here because he died. I don't know if you understand that you have been loved so much. I have been loved so much. Somebody died on my behalf. I was supposed to have perished in my sins. But he took my place. And here we are today. We are called sons and daughters of God. I would wish to see somebody standing with me and say, "Thank you, Jesus." Just for maybe for 30 seconds. What a beautiful love story that Jesus brought upon us. You may stand up on your feet. We just want to say, "Thank you, Jesus." I'm going to preach very soon, and we shall be enjoying. You look so beautiful. You look so beautiful. You look so handsome. Man of God, you look so handsome. I can tell you who is covering. He's ready for the resurrection. He's going to heaven with Jesus. You can see him. Look at him. Ah, three-piece suit. Ah, Jesus. Ah. Father, we thank you. We can all say something. Father, we bless you. We honor you. We give you glory. We give you praise. In the name of Jesus, for the love that you have shown us, for the death on the cross of Calvary. Jesus, we thank you today and forever. We bless your holy name, God Almighty. Because, oh God, you have loved us beyond measure. And you care about us. Today, oh God, we have seen your love. Resurrection Sunday to us is our new birth. Our newness in you, oh God. And we thank you, God, for this wonderful day. We thank you, Jesus. We are joining millions and billions of people all over the globe who are celebrating the birth of the church, the birth of the powerful church through the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you and I bless you. I honor you in the name of Jesus. We say, "Take your glory because you are faithful." Dying for somebody else is something else, let alone dying for billions of people. Father, you are full of love. We thank you. We take this time seriously and bless your holy name. We say you are God and you are faithful. You are too faithful to us, even when we are not faithful to you and to us, to ourselves. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, we bless you. Thank you for your death. Thank you for the cross. Thank you for the empty grave. Thank you for your resurrection. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for coming back to life so that we will not die again. In Jesus' mighty and glorious name. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Let us step in for Jesus.
You will sit down as we start preaching the word of God. The name Jesus is so beautiful to pronounce and to talk about, to sing about and to read about. That's the reason why we are celebrating today, because of this wonderful name, the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. I want us to go into the preaching of the word of God. The topic was sent yesterday. And the topic says, just like he said he would, he did it. Say with me, just like he said, he did it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want us to go and read the book of Matthew, chapter number 28. We have heard the story of Jesus dying on the cross. We know about this story very well. But today, allow me to start off by saying the grave could not hold Jesus based on the power of the resurrection that God awarded him. Hallelujah. Talk to me, somebody. Hallelujah. The grave could not stand the power Jesus came up with. So often as people, we fail. Sometimes we fail even in our assignments at work. But Jesus did not fail in our assignments. He passed our assignments, he passed our examinations, so that we may become powerful. That's the reason why Paul says in the book of Romans 8, verse number 11, the very same power that raised Jesus from the dead resides on the inside of us. Talk to me, somebody.
Amen.
If Jesus rose from the dead, it means you will rise again in your situation.
Amen.
It doesn't matter whether it's smelling or the situation has been too old, attached to you. But one thing for sure that we know is Jesus gave us a latitude to step on and still say, we shall make it. Because he made a way for us. Hallelujah. I want us to read the book of Matthew, chapter number 28. We can read from verse number 1 to verse number 8. But I only sealed these two beautiful venetians there. The first one is verse number 8, the second verse number 6, verse 38, I read. He is not here. Say, he is not here. For he has risen. Say with me, for he has risen. Then we all read the green part. What is it saying?
Just as he said,
he would come, see the place where he was lying. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, this is the main money that we are given, that he has risen from the dead. And behold, he is going ahead of you into Galilee, as he promised. There you will see him. Behold, I have told you. Thank you, Jesus. Two statements that are similar but said in two different ways. The first one is just as he said. The second one says, behold, I have told you. Hallelujah. Listen, when you live with people and people keep on saying something, I grew up saying with my grandma, and she would say words that will echo even now that she's no more.
the story here. When Jesus was still God, not revealed in the manner of a person, in the book of Isaiah, it was said, a virgin shall conceive and shall bring forth a son, and his name shall be Emmanuel, which means God is with us. Listen to me. As long as you still believe in Jesus, the Lord is with you. It doesn't matter what type of a situation you are confronted with. The fact of the matter is, God is with his people. Which means when you go through a problem, you have got a partner in the problem. You did not get that one. You have got a partner in your circumstances. That's the reason why you are still alive today. If the partner Emmanuel, which means God is with us, had left you when you went through a problem, we would have chosen a wonderful Saturday to bury you. You are still alive today because Emmanuel is with us.
Amen.
God is with us.
Amen.
God is with you.
Amen.
God is taking care of your business. There are times when you can't even pray in your life. But you must know, as long as Emmanuel is still God, he is praying on your behalf.
Amen.
That's the reason why we don't have to let go of God. We better let go of people than letting go of God. Because God does not leave his people.
Amen.
He said, I shall be with you until the end of time. And this is proof enough to us, Brother Lord, that Jesus came. And when he came, he did not just come, he came on a prophetic mission. And the mission was to come and die for us. But guess what? If Jesus is God, he's not going to remain in the grave forever.
Yeah.
That's the reason why it is written today that just as he said, what did he say? I will come, die, but will rise again.
Yeah.
As long as Jesus has risen, as long as Jesus has been resurrected from the dead, you shall rise this year in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't care what you are coming across. I don't want to know the situation, Pastor Lombardi. But one thing that I know is Emmanuel is with us. He does not leave his people. And guess what? When he comes, he has got a mission. I don't know if you know the mission is to take you from here. Then he places you here. Then he takes you away from here. And he takes you higher. Listen to me, does not end there. Because if you are just higher, you can fall. But he takes you from higher to eternity. I love that tune. It sounds like tune. The cause of that tune.
Yeah.
Waitata la. Listen, your la, my la, was not good enough. That's the reason why there was a grace. So the grace could not hurt Jesus until he takes you from here to this side. So that you may know that he's gracious. He loves you. He loves you. He loves us.
Lives.
We love the Father because Jesus loves the Father. We pray because Jesus prays. Which means we can only do what Jesus has done. And when we do it, we are not boring God. We are proving to Him that we are His children. Just like Jesus did. I want us to look into this. Very soon, we shall be going home. Just like He said. What did He say? Number one, He said, He will die, He will be persecuted. He will be handed over to sinful people. And He will die. But He will rise again. The very same is happening in your life. Maybe your situation is bad and buried. Thank God it's still day number two in your life. But on the third day, your situation will rise with you. Things will change around you. There shall be money in your house. There shall be food in your fridges. There shall be furniture in your house. You will have a house just like other people have houses. You will drive just like other people are driving. Do you know the reason why? When Jesus rose from the dead, He was even pointing you and I to the very same situation that He was in. That it is possible, as long as you walk with God, to rise again.
Amen.
You will rise again. Don't give up, just hold on. A little longer, you are going to rise very soon. Now, I want us to go to the next, we have got a few slides here. Number one, I want you to understand Jesus Christ's resurrection. This was not just a fluke. It was a mission accomplished.
Amen.
It was not just a coincidence. It was a mission planned and accomplished.
Amen.
We need to understand the following. Jesus was prophesied. And He came. It happened. Apart from that, Jesus Christ spoke about it. What is it? I will rise again. And guess what? It happened again. Now, we need to understand the following. What is it that Jesus did in the 3 days when He was in the grave? I don't know if you allow me to put this mic down so that I can also move freely. I'll use it when we get to the next part. Now, listen to me, Zalona. Listen to me very attentively because we are about to conclude this. There are 5 things that I want to talk about that Jesus did when He was in the grave. From Friday to Sunday morning. The first thing that He did was to fulfill the scriptures.
Amen.
I believe there was a very big God of honor in heaven.
Yes.
To honor Him as He comes. Jesus moved from the cross to the grave. He did not end in the grave. He went to glory. And as He was getting there, let me tell you this. There was a God of honor.
Amen.
And the God of honor was telling us that it is possible one day we shall go to glory.
Amen.
No matter how difficult our situations are, if we hold on to God's unchanging hand, we shall one day appear in glory with Christ Jesus.
Amen.
The first thing that Jesus went to do when He was in the grave was to go and say to the Father, "It is finished."
Amen.
We did not understand it when He said it when He was hanging on the cross. Until He went to heaven. And when He went to heaven, angels were clapping.
Jesus.
There was a very big commotion in
in heaven.
Amen.
They were saying, our God is back.
Amen.
He completed the mission.
Amen.
He's back with power.
Amen.
And when God looked at him, this is what God did. He bestowed upon him, he conferred upon him a name above all names.
Amen.
We did not get that one. That at the sound of his name, every knee must bow and tongues must confess that he is Lord. That's the reason why even the day he died, when the world, was looking at him, dying on the cross, listen to me, the soldiers, the brigadiers, the commanders in the army were looking at him. He did not perform a miracle on that day. Because the biggest miracle was performed by nature. When nature saw Jesus dying on the cross, nature said, we have never seen this. Then in the Holy of Holies, the curtain was torn. Which means you can get in. You can get an hour. You can get. You can get. The very same time Jesus died, dead people who had died long ago woke up and had to walk in the city. And the Bible says they were seen by people. They went into places, they were seen by people. If you don't believe me, just go and read the book of Matthew 27 from verse number 51. You will understand what I'm talking about. When this happened, the Bible says the third thing was a very huge darkness. The darkness was actually saying, now your sin that you might have committed in the dark is now taken away. And guess what happened afterwards? Immediately after your sin, my sin, our sins have been taken away. The last thing that happened was things started to shake. There was an earthquake. I'm telling you today, prophetically, your life is about to shake.
Yes.
Things are falling in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
All the things that were troubling you are falling in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Do you know the reason why? He resurrected with power.
Yes.
And he shall come back with power. Because you live in power. Because you are full of power. You believe in the God who has got power. Therefore, you cannot live without power.
Amen.
Jesus Christ. And guess what? Immediately after all these things that happened, the Bible says the very same people who were crucifying him bowed down.
Amen.
And they said, truly, this is the thing. They did not say he was. Is, which means the gospel is still going on. It did not end with Jesus dying. It is moving forward because we are. Hallelujah. Can I preach just for some few minutes? Listen to me. The death of Jesus was just an introduction into the church. Was just an introduction into your salvation. It does not end on the cross of Jesus. It ends in glory.
Amen.
We are going to glory very soon.
Amen.
It does not end there. That's the reason why the topic today is saying, just like he said.
Amen.
Listen to me. Just like he said, you shall rise.
Amen.
Just like he said, this year things are going to change in your life.
Amen.
I'm not looking at the pandemic. Because when you look at the pandemic, you are using a human mind. Faith is not things that we see.
Yeah.
It's only things that we hope for.
Yeah.
Because in hope, there is no disappointment.
Yeah.
When you hope for God to act, he shall surely deliver. Yeah. When you hope for God to heal you, he will heal you.
Yeah.
Because in him, there is no failure.
Yeah.
In him, there is no Jesus. That was the first thing that he came to do. I feel like going on, but let me quickly rush, because I wanted to go back home very, very, very quickly. Number two. Oh, Jesus, we bless you here. He went to preach in prison. You did not get that one. The book of 1 Peter chapter number 3, verse number 19 says, he went and proclaimed God's salvation to earlier generations who ended up in the prison of judgment because they would not listen. When we read the voice, it says, that one was the message. The voice says, verse number 19, and in the spirit of spirit, he went and preached to the spirits in prison. Probably either fallen angels imprisoned by God for the day of judgment. Listen, on the day he died, the reason why it took 3 days, he had a mission. One of the mission parts was to travel into the land of the spirits to preach to those spirits who did not believe in God. Those ones who fell from grace. Those ones who did not even want God in their lives. And when he went to them, guess what he preached about? This is what he said. Just like I said I will come and die for you. You never believed in my gospel. Just like I said, I have died. It won't end in me dying, but it shall end in me rising. Amen. He went to preach the very same message, just like I said. And I know a lot of you never heard about this verse. You are hearing about it for the first time today. And let me teach you this. When Jesus was in the grave, he was having a mission, Pastor Norman. Okay. The mission number one was to go back to the Father and say, it is finished. Then the second mission was, I have told you, just like I said, I died and now I'm going to rise again. And the Bible records that these spirits are in chains. They are waiting for the day of judgment. But Jesus went to preach to them. And what was the message? The message was saying, just like I said. And I believe those ones who died in Christ were celebrating in heaven. They were singing a song, we are the children. He amen. He amen. They were looking at him from Calvary to the grave. He amen. He amen. He amen. If your God never went to Calvary, don't trust him. Him, he's not God. That is another thing that I cannot talk about. If your prophet never died for you and rose from the dead, never trust him. Trust the one who hanged on Calvary. Trust the one who went to the grave. Trust the one who rose from the dead. Trust the one who's sitting at the right hand of the Father, making intercessions on our behalf. That is the one you need to trust. Hallelujah. Amen. Let me quickly rush. Number four. Is it number four or number three? Number three. Listen. One of the missions he had to accomplish was to go into all those areas which had the powers to take on the powers. You did not get that one. He went to all the strongholds. He went to all the kingdoms and the governments. of authority. And when he went there, he took powers. He vindicated each and everyone who thought he was God. And made him a footstool for you to rise. He took the keys.
Amen.
Number three, let us read. He took the keys of hell. You did not get that one. And the ever living one, living in and beyond all time and space, I died, but I see, but see, I am alive forevermore, and I have the keys of absolute control and victory over death and hate. Hate is the realm of the dead. Listen to me. There is a realm of the dead. In that realm, they only think about who to kill next. So Jesus, before you could be killed, before I could be killed, he had to have 3 days leave from his duties so that he could go into all these realms. One of them is a realm of the dead, where he went to take your name out from their registers. You were supposed to have died long ago. Amen. You were supposed to have been buried and forgotten.
Amen.
But guess what? When Jesus died, he went to this area. He took the keys. I believe he buried the books where your names were written, where my name was written. And he came back and he said, because I live from the end to the beginning and from the beginning to the end. He said in the book of Matthew, chapter number 18, verse number 18, whatever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven.
Amen.
Do you know the reason why? It is because even the realm of the Persian king, even the realm of the principalities, even the realm of the governors, even the realm of the dead people cannot hold you down any longer.
Amen.
It is because you went there first. He came back just for you. Now he has got power. And he says, I will give you these powers. That whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. I'm binding each and every demon that was planning your downfall this year in the name of Jesus. I bind each and every spirit of death, each and every angel of death in the name of Jesus. I am saying you shall live this year. No poverty is attached to your name in the name of Jesus. No bankruptcy in the name of Jesus. Your cars, your houses will never be taken in the name of Jesus. Do you know the reason why? Jesus took all the keys. He has given you the powers now. Move in the power of the resurrected one. He's alive. Women were saying today in the morning, I love women. Because wherever there are women in the ministry, things move.
Yeah.
Peter had denied Jesus and had fallen back. But the women did not give up on Jesus.
Yeah.
They were going to bound him, to embalm him with spices in the morning when they got the good news. Do not blame women for preaching the gospel.
Yeah.
They took it from the day Jesus had risen. I know there are pastors all over the world who are saying, women must not preach the gospel. Who are you to say such? If the gospel, the first message of resurrection were given to women. And the Bible says, go quickly and tell my disciples. Those disciples were men who could not wait to see Jesus resurrected. But women stood and shook the kingdom. When they went back with the good news, they said, he's alive.
Yeah.
He's risen.
Yeah.
He's going to meet you in Galilee. Galilee means the place of power.
Yes.
You cannot go to Galilee and come back the same person.
Yes.
You cannot go back to Galilee and come back Peter. Yeah. Because Galilee is the area of power.
Yeah.
How can we go to number four? We go to number four by saying, Jesus has given you enough powers. Jesus, I think from verse number 10. It says in the book, is it the book of Judges? The Bible says, Gideon, go in the very same strength of the power that you have. Then listen, if you want to preach the gospel, Pastor Joel, do not go into Matthias' power.
Yeah.
Do not go into so-and-so's power.
Yeah.
Do not take any person's power. Yeah. Jesus has already given you the power.
Amen.
You have the power in you. You can make things happen in the name of Jesus. Women, I want to challenge you. Young people, I want to challenge you. You have got power, Pastor Nombali. Do not compromise when you stand here.
Yes.
Command the power of heaven. Because Jesus has given you the power.
Yeah.
Number 4. What was Jesus doing, man of God, in the grave? When he was in the grave, he was in a serious mission. And his mission was, number 4, what is it? Hey. He went to the Father. You did not get this one. Number 4 says, Jesus went to the Father. This time he did not use the blood of goats. He did not use the blood of doves and goats and bulls.
Okay.
He used his own blood. He took it, I believe it was the flesh. He went to the Father and he said, Father, look at this. This is my blood. And now I want to make a plea with you. I plead with you that these people may be saved through this blood.
Amen.
That's the reason why you sing to the Lord, the blood of Jesus. I say, oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood of no more judgment in your life.
Amen.
You are no more condemned. And once for all took blood into that inner room, he did not just go to the courts. He went to the inner room where the Father is, into the Holy of Holies, where nobody gets in and comes back alive. But when he went there, he was holding his blood. He was dripping with blood. And he was saying, Father, these people. Now, look at this. The last verse says, no, he took his own blood. And with it, he, by himself, not prophet this time, not priest this time. I know you trust pastors so much. I know you trust the apostles and bishops and teachers of the word so much, evangelists and prophets so much. But now Jesus is entering saying, I'm taking you, not, I mean with me, I'm taking you in me to the Father. Listen to me. There's a difference from walking with God. And I mean, there is a, it is also different from being in God. Now, when you become born again, you do not move with God. You move in God. That's the reason why he took us in his blood. And he went with us to the Father. Even before you were born again, that's the reason why the Bible tells us that it was predestined that you shall be born again. You are not here by coincidence. It is because Jesus took you in his blood to the Father, in the Holy of Holies. And when he went there, listen to me, This is what he did. He presented you together with him. That's the reason why the book of Colossians chapter 3, verse number 3, the Bible says, don't you know that you have died? For your life is hidden with Christ in God. You are now in God. You are not in the world. Yes, you might talk like us. You might be a Zulu speaking, a Thomas speaker, a Pepper speaker, far not many in the world or whatever. But let me tell you something. As long as you are standing in Christ, you are not of the world. Because you are in Christ. That's the reason why when you are sick, because you are in Christ, the blood of Jesus heals you. I'm telling you mysteries today. These are revelations that you have never heard. You are in Christ. And guess what? You went into the Holy of Holies. You went to the Father, which means if you sin and die and go to hell, it is not the will of Jesus. If you are a powerful Christian and now you have gone back, it is not the will of Jesus. If you shall be condemned and go to hell, it is not the will of Jesus. Because you went into God's holy place with Jesus, and he came back with you and me, so that we can have this wonderful convocation that is called a church service today. If you go to hell, it's no longer because Jesus did not love you, it's because you are cruel to yourself. You have been to glory with Jesus. When he came back with you so that you could go and preach to other people, to go to glory, now you give up on God. You can't give up on God.
Amen.
I don't believe he brought me this far to leave me. He did not bring me this far to leave me.
Yeah.
The biggest problem with you is you are too much of a selfish, carnal person. You are too selfish. Jesus is generous. He took us with him into the Holy of Holies. He came back with us so that we may do his job. But we want to go to hell. We are evil and he's righteous. Stand up on your feet. I want to say this. The last part of this message is found in the book of Isaiah 53, verse number 12. The last part. I want to read for you because I know you won't read. I'm doing you a favor. You were supposed to be paying me for all these things. You never knew what Jesus went to the grave for. But the last part that I want to talk about is not the only, these are not the only things, the five things. The last one, it's found, I did not write it down because I did not want to waste my ink. I want you to take it back home and understand it. Verse number 12, the last part of verse number 12. I read this one for you. You can have it, using your own, version. But this one made me happy. It says, the last part, after the last comma there, Isaiah 53, verse number 12, the last part of that book, it says, using my own version, somebody may read it for us, maybe in, what is this, the Message or any other version, two or three versions, now we can conclude this. We are going to pray now. I read mine, it says, and makes intercession for the transgressors. Verse number 12, the last part, humbleness. What is your saying? Oh, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Worship team, come back, please.
My Jesus,
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 Because this name is different.
Yes.
If it's what people are turning against you, you will have a name. Because of us.
Amen.
May God bless you.